Дорогие друзья!
Dear friends, I am glad to welcome you to my channel. As promised, I will continue to answer your questions. Today, we are launching the third episode. Thank you for your support and interest in my previous video releases. Now, let's get down to business and answer the first question. Why is it taking so long to build the Yus Sky Center in Sharjah? Firstly, it is important to understand that USD technology is a highly complex industry-forming technology related to transport and infrastructure. Analogs of this technology include industries such as railway transport, which encompasses railways, rolling stock, infrastructure, and a full cycle of developing and producing specific materials, components, assemblies, equipment and systems of railways, rail vehicles and railway infrastructure. A railway transport is not limited to any single system, such as a rail grade, bridge, locomotive, car, train station, depot or plant for the production of locomotives and cars. Rather, railway transport is a complex system that includes dozens of different systems and subsystems, each of which is essential to the overall operation of the railway. At the same time, the modern global railway industry was created with the participation of states, not only private companies. This has been taking place in many countries for more than 200 years. Similar developments have occurred in other transport and infrastructure sectors, such as the automotive, rocket, space, naval, and aviation industries. The only company that was able to come closer to implementing a new transport and infrastructure project before the USD group of companies is Siemens. However, we must remember that this company has about 300,000 employees and an annual revenue of about 100 billion euros. Even in this case, the major investor in the development of the Transrapid Magnetically Levitated Transportation and Infrastructure Complex was not this company itself, but the German state. Several billion euros were invested in this project, which was officially carried out for over 40 years, starting in 1969, although in fact work on the maglev train started before World War II. The project has now been closed due to the extreme low energy efficiency of the Transrapid system and low level of transportation security. The construction of infrastructure facilities depends not only on the amount of funding, but also on the development of technical and design solutions, as well as the availability and supply of a wide range of materials, components, assemblies, and equipment. It also depends on the geopolitical situation in the world, the presence of sanctions against companies and individuals involved in a particular project, and a number of other economic, social, and geopolitical factors that influence the global economy. This means that our current work cannot be easily compared, for example, with the period from 2016 to 2019, when the Eco-Techno Park in the city of Marina Gorka was actively being built in Belarus. Today, due to the bankruptcies of a number of European supplier companies during the COVID-19 pandemic and the lockdowns, as well as the aggravated geopolitical situation in the world, resulted in the imposition of sanctions, the costs of components and equipment for the USD technology have increased significantly. Moreover, short test tracks with a moving load of up to 10 tons and a total string tension of up to 500 tons have been built in the Belarusian Eco-Techno Park. It should be noted that these are short test tracks up to 800 to 900 meters in length, while heavy, with a moving load of up to 60 tons and a string tension of up to 2,000 tons, and long, up to 2.5 kilometers in length, USD complexes are being constructed in the United Arab Emirates. Therefore, the question should be asked in a different way. How does the UST group of companies manage to not only work successfully, but also develop in such difficult financial and economic conditions, with adjusted for inflation investment volume, which has decreased? This indicates the effective and targeted utilization of investments while minimizing scientific, technological, organizational, and economic risks. Due to these factors, most startups in the world have ceased to exist, thus zeroing out the funds invested in them. I would like to touch on another aspect in my current response. Earlier, some of you asked me why we have built two demonstration and certification centers in different places, in Belarus and the United Arab Emirates. The current geopolitical situation provides us with an answer. Thanks to this decision that I made earlier, we are able to continue working and demonstrating our UST technology to the entire world, as well as receiving orders for targeted projects. Why is the name Skyway no longer relevant? In the period between 2015 and the end of 2019, the UST group of companies carried out some of its activities under the marketing names of Skyway and Skyway Group. It is worth emphasizing that these companies or groups with these names have never existed legally and do not exist as organized and legal entities. In addition to the companies that were directly part of the UST group of companies, the Skyway brand, namely Sky, which is part of my surname as the author of the technology in English, Unitsky, was used by a number of companies beyond our control, as well as by a number of investment funds and independent uncontrolled persons, as part of a crowd investing model, aimed to raising funds for the development of my engineering activities. Subsequently, the UST group of companies has refused to use any names related to Skyway due to a number of unfair and fraudulent actions by agent companies. We have repeatedly appealed to authorities and courts in different countries to protect our honor, dignity, and business reputation. Lawsuits have been filed against unscrupulous competitors, as well as those who serve their interests or have been misled by the attacks of unscrupulous media. In some cases, these lawsuits were successful, however, in other cases, they were not. In 2019, the parent engineering company rebranded and changed its logo and name. The corporate style elements were updated as well. The new brand of the company in English, Unitsky String Technologies Incorporated, combines both the name of the technology that started it all and my last name as its author, Unitsky. By the way, this was reflected in the charter of the company when it was founded back in 2015.
Друзья, благодарю вас за внимание.
Dear friends, thank you for your attention. I was glad to get in touch with you again and answer your questions. See you again in the next video episode.
Всего доброго.